Hello, everybody. Happy Friday. Thanks for chilling with me on this Friday. I am the sports judge. Man, the Dallas Mavericks take a 2-0 lead, protect home court, and now the series goes back to Dallas. Minnesota couldn't win one game at home. And you know, for me, Luka has been the best player in this series. It's been fun to watch Luka put the entire league on notice with his brilliance, his unbelievable play that we're seeing night in and night out. Anytime I watch Luka play, I am amazed. I am always amazed by what he can do on the floor. You can take what you want from this game tonight, but Luka is that guy. He's just ridiculous. And listen, I know he hasn't been consistently great during this playoff run, hasn't been his efficient self in every single game, but when his team needed him to take over, he has. Once again, he showed up when the Mavs needed him to. He made all the right plays to propel his team. This man lives for the big moments. I got mad love for Luka. How many times have we seen Luka come into somebody else's house and do what he did tonight? It's been countless times. And when he hit that dagger three, I said it then. I said, yep, this game is over. Luka just delivered the game winner. That might have ended this series. Just when you thought the Wolves were going to hand the Dallas Mavericks a loss in game two, they let them back in the game. The resilience of the Mavs doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter how much they're down. They just keep playing and battling. The continuity that they have and the trust, you can see it, and they don't panic. It's good to see. I can't believe what we just witnessed. I'm still stunned. We can clearly see the look in the eyes of Luka from what we witnessed in the two games. It speaks to the joy he plays with. The fire in his eyes undoubtedly shows. What we're seeing from him has been incredible. That's the dog that we always talk about. Luka is just the fourth player in NBA history with four playoff triple-doubles in a five-game span. Let's just face it, guys. Right now, Luka is the best player left in these playoffs. So I would think the Mavs are favored to win this series with the way Luka is playing. He's the hottest player right now. I hope the Wolves, you know, snap out of it at some point, but clearly nobody can stop Luka. You knew you had to win this game tonight, and now you have to go on the road and try to win two in their place. You're in a world of trouble going to Dallas trailing 2-0. On top of that, you can't guard Luka when he's on fire. You just can't. It's impossible. Now, I know I was going crazy screaming about Anthony Edwards, and I'm keeping that same energy because I truly think he's on his way to becoming the face of the NBA. Obviously, the Timberwolves are in a tough spot, being down 2-0 against a very good Dallas team with a top five star who has put his imprint on every important part of this series. I mean, oh man, I'm just not sure if Minnesota can stop Luka. He just shot the Timberwolves right in the hearts. The rush to immediately crown Anthony Edwards, and I'm guilty of this, to crown him the next MJ, and he'll get there. But we proclaimed him the next Michael Jordan, and look, Ant hasn't been playing that well. Since his 44-point game versus the Nuggets, he has taken a completely different turn. What's going on with him? Ant has noticeably been below 20 points in recent games. The points are not coming. He has had a couple of big playoff games, but it's been sketchy. How does he go from being so hot to non-existent? I mean, it could be a lot worse, but they need him to play better. Ant should be able to step up when he needs to. His offense has regressed. His playmaking hasn't been that great. And his defense is not even where it was. You know, I think I'm going to stop with the MJ talk. I'm going to pump the brakes a bit, even though I still think he has a lot of MJ in him. It's his first deep playoff run. The reality is he likely is starting to wear down. You can give him, you know, the hit the wall and run out of gas excuse. Everybody is tired. You have to play through it. If you are to elevate to top tier, can he get back to his normal self? He's having a bad series. It happens. Understandable when you've never been in this situation. He's 22. I believe he will get better, but Luka is outshining him on the floor in this series. I don't understand why the Wolves didn't blitz him on that possession and make literally anyone else beat him. How do you not have a second guy on Luka? Gotta bring help. He already warned you that Rudy Gobert can't guard him. You saw the trash talk out there. At least not by himself. And Gobert is the last person you want guarding him because he's not a very good one-on-one defender. Luka is going to cook anybody one-on-one in any situation because he's that damn good. There's not a player alive who is stopping Luka one-on-one. If you play back, he's making that three. If you play up on him, he's going to the rim and getting fouled. It's a no-win situation. That's why I say you have to double Luka there. I'm not ready to say it's over. It's still a series if Ant and Cat stop playing around and eventually show up. Your two best players have been no-shows the first two games and have lost by a combined 4 points. Your team has lost by a combined 4 points. The wild part about this, all the Wolves blow an 18-point lead. Ant and Cat shot a combined 9 of 33, and Minnesota managed to lose by one. Now imagine if both Ant and Cat played any better in games one and two, we probably would be talking differently about this series. And when you play poorly in the second half, not able to execute, make anything happen, or hit clutch shots, you're not going to stop a team like the Dallas Mavericks from going on a crazy run to get back in the game. This is the second time that they lost at home, and now their season is in peril. Their ambitions are never more vulnerable than right now in the wake of what was a must win. And now the Wolves season may end on Tuesday because the hopes of their first NBA Finals appearance are suddenly on the ropes. I'm not making excuses, but Ant looks tired. And I was saying this throughout the game. Why is he shooting so many threes? But when you're tired, you settle for jumpers. It's easier to pull up from 26 feet and pull up for a 26-foot jumper than it is to drive strong to the basket. You don't necessarily need to drive. Ant could take a few steps in and hit two, which he's good at. I'll be surprised to see Ant not wake up and finally get going in this series. It's kind of agonizing when Minnesota loses such an important game in this fashion. These 30% shooting games from Anthony Edwards can't can't keep happening. It can't. The game was lost when they blew a large lead at home. You're up by 18. You're settling for jumpers, just taking any damn shot instead of driving the damn ball and drawing fouls to get to the line. Minnesota has to smash the paint more often. Two incredible games from their role players, and still you lose the game. McDaniels and Anderson had to carry the load the last game, and Naz Reid did his thing tonight because the stars have disappeared. The next game, Anthony Edwards has to ball out. If not, we can say this series is over. Thanks for watching, everyone. Really appreciate the love and support. Thanks for watching my channel, as always. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. We'll talk very soon. See you guys later.